Good evening to all of you, and welcome back, and welcome to the seventh day of the add-on course on gender studies offered by the Department of English, HPB Girls College. Before we begin our session for today, I would like to welcome Ma'am Meetu Dusset to this platform, and thank you so much, ma'am. I, on behalf of the Department of English, would like to sincerely thank for your time, for your time that which you will be giving. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your presence today. And let me quickly go a little bit of an introduction for today's research person. That is Dr. Meetu Dusset is an assistant professor in the Department of English, M.C. Das College, Silchar. And her PhD thesis is the portrayal of women in selected works of fiction of Margaret Lawrence, A Feminist Reading. So this is for today. And so without much further ado, I would like to hand over to ma'am now to start her session. Ma'am, it is over to you, ma'am.
Thank you very much. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Bipul Chandra Bhuiya sir, principal sir, principal HPB Girls College, then Dr. Polash Hundikoy, IQSC coordinator, HPB Girls College, and especially Dr. Deepa Phukan Borua, ma'am, head of the Department of English, HPB Girls College, and course coordinator Dr. Dibbajyoti Bora, and Dr. Santulan Mohanto, Dr. Mr. Mangal Singh Rongfar, and Mr. Akarjyoti Sharma. So let me introduce myself. I am Dr. Meetu Dusset, and we have first of all, I like to introduce myself as a lover of literature in today's session. I don't want to bring all my identities, but today I just want to discuss this session as a lover of literature. Here I want to talk with you as a student of literature. Okay, we are all students of literature. We are all, especially I'm a lover of literature, and we all love literature, and that's why we are here. So, as you have already participated in some of the lectures of this add-on course on gender studies, first of all, before starting my lecture, before directly going to this text, that is A Room of One's Own, I want to like ask some question. I want to talk to you, at least some of the students. I want to know something, like I want to ask some basic question, because I want this session to be an interactive one. You can answer both in English and in SMS, whatever language you are comfortable. Okay, I do understand all these two both the languages. So anyone who want to volunteer for answering my question, you can raise your hands. Am I audible? If you just want to volunteer.
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
I just want some of the students to answer some of the basic question, you don't have to be afraid of the question. So can you just do, can I have some volunteers? If you want to answer the question, please raise your hands. I will ask a very simple question. I just don't want to just discuss the text and then just leave. Okay, that's why I want you to also talk into this session. That's why I want to ask some basic question. Anyone who wants to answer, please raise your hand. Seema Gogoi has raised your hand. Thank you very much. So, your name, you are from which semester?
Ma'am, fifth semester, SPB Girls College.
English department only?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you are from English department. Okay, thank you. Thank you for raising your hand. The thing is that I just want to ask some basic question. Okay, don't be afraid. I want to talk and just make it comfortable, okay, before just going to the lecture directly. That's why I'm asking some questions. So your name is Seema Gogoi and you are studying in SPB Girls College in the Department of English, fifth semester, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, can you tell me what's your aim in life?
To be an administrative officer.
Okay, very nice. To be an administrative officer. And can you tell me how many siblings do you have? Siblings
one
means brother.
Brother. One brother. Elder
you
brother.
You have one elder brother. He is doing something, no?
Studying. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. He has a job.
Okay, he is already a job. No, he has already a job. Like he is how many years elder than you, older than you?
5 years.
5 years. Oh, so the thing is that you are and your can you tell me, because you are from English literature, can you tell me who is your favorite writer?
Yes, ma'am. There are so many. Jhumpa Lahiri is my favorite. I have read only one novel, The Lowland.
Okay.
Tar porai mu mane bhal lagile.
Okay, very nice. Hoi gol na tumak moi hudilu aru next aru kono ba answer koriba eneka question kita moi hudibo lage mane aru kono ba volunteer koriba eneka simple question e hudim moi eneka same question. Anyone please raise your hand. Are ola kotha sota patim aru class to korime class hodai kori thaku na ola already 7 ta class korila tumi tumaloke sorry tumaloke hoto already 7 ta class korila ola kotha sota patilo time waste no koru tumar class to pora dim aru kon bar raise your hand please. Okay, Brishti Dotto, so introduce yourself, please.
Good evening, ma'am. I am a fifth semester student of SPB Girls College, English Department.
English Department, okay. Then same question. The same question, three questions I have asked her, just answer them. Means what's your aim in life and all that?
For aim, ma'am, I don't have a definite aim in life right now, but I just want to complete my graduation and further do my master's in English.
Okay.
And then for like siblings, I have one younger brother.
A younger brother, okay. And then this your favorite writer?
I like R.K. Narayan and Salman Rushdie, and also I like Haruki Murakami's writing also.
Okay, very nice. Anyone else? Thank you. I'll come back to you later. Okay. Let me ask some more question to other students. Anyone else who wants to introduce themselves? Anyone? Please carry on. Anyone else? Okay, Ankita Chetri. Okay, please introduce yourself.
First of all, good evening, ma'am. I'm Ankita Chetri, a student of BA fifth semester of Department of English of HPB Girls College.
Okay.
And my aim in life is to become an administrative officer.
Okay.
I also have a sibling and he is my younger brother and he is now studying.
Okay. And your favorite writer?
I have various favorite writers, but I have recently
read
Ma'am Bronte Sisters.
Okay, Bronte Sisters. Okay, thank you. Anyone else? I can handle two more students. Can introduce yourself. Five students will do. Anyone else? Anyone else who wants to talk, who wants to participate? ইমানো বেয়া নহয় দেই, অলপ কথা চথা পাতা আৰু। Anyone else? Pratyashi. Pratyashi, please introduce yourself.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
My fifth semester, a student হয় English department. Ma'am, more sibling, more সৰু ভণ্টি এজনী আছে। Aim in life, মানে তেনেকুৱা মানে এটা ডেফিনিট এইম নাই, কিন্তু মোৰ টিচিং ভাল লাগে। মোৰ ফেভৰেট ৰাইটাৰ মানে এনেকুৱা বহুত কিতাপ বা তেনেকুৱা ৰাইটাৰ আছে মোৰ ফেভৰেট হয়। আৰু মই ৰিচেণ্টলি ৰেইনব' ৰয়েলৰ মানে ফেন হয়।
হৈ গল ন? আৰু কোনোবা কিবা কবা নেকি? কবলৈ মন যায় কোৱা, পিছত মই ষ্টাৰ্টো কৰিব লাগিব ন? এনিৱান এলচ? আই কেন হেভ অনলি ওৱান মোৰ ষ্টুডেণ্ট। নকলে মই ষ্টাৰ্ট কৰি দিম, কোৱা আৰু কৰিবা নেকি?
ভাল লাগে বিশেষকৈ ভাল লাগে।
লিটাৰেচাৰ হ'লেই হ'ল, মানে ৰাইটাৰ হ'লেই হ'ল, এইটো তোমাৰ ভাল লগা। আৰু তোমাৰ চিবলিং, ভাই ভণ্টি? অ'কে, আই থিংক দেৰ ৱাজ এন টেকনিকেল গ্লিচ। অ'কে, দেট উইল ডু, ফাইভ ষ্টুডেণ্টছ হেভ আনচাৰ, থেংক ইউ ভেৰি মাছ। So the thing is that let me start the lecture. Okay, I will bring on why I have asked this kind of question to you. Let me just start first. So let me just start first. Okay, A Room of One's Own, essay by Virginia Woolf, published in 1921. The work was based on two lectures given by the author in 1928 at Newnham College and Garton College, the first two colleges for women at Cambridge. Woolf addressed the status of women and women artists in particular in this famous essay, which asserts that a woman must have money and a room of her own if she is right to she is to write. So this is basically this is like the brief introduction of the text A Room of One's Own. Okay, Virginia Woolf, she was invited to give a lecture, two lectures actually, in two of the colleges under Cambridge University. Okay, then the thing is that she went there and she Woolf addressed what, the status of women, the then status of women and women artists in particular in this famous essay, that is in this famous essay, that is the famous essay, that is A Room of One's Own. She will be discussing the status of women. So basically I have structured my lecture in seven parts. Okay, first I will give you a brief introduction of the text, then I will give you the setting of the text, and then the analysis of the text, then the symbols. She has used various symbols in this text. Okay, and then the themes, then the character analysis, and then conclusion. Okay, if you have any doubt later on I will take question, just first let me complete it. So I have given you the brief introduction of the text. Now, according to Woolf, in this text she has discussed that according to her, centuries of prejudice and financial and educational disadvantages have inhibited women's creativity. Okay. The thing is that in this very essay, before that, people used to think, society as a whole used to think that women are bad writers. Okay, they can't write, they don't have the potentiality to write good literature. But Wolf, in this very text, she wanted to say that because women, it's not that women are like bad writers. It's not that they don't have the intellectual or that is potentiality to write good literature, to create good literature. But the thing is that they were not given the basic necessities. The basic necessities have not been fulfilled when it comes to a woman. Okay, so that's why they can write properly. They cannot create good literature. So that's why to illustrate this, she offers the example of an hypothetical imaginary but gifted sister of Shakespeare as a student of literature, like any kind of literature, whether it's ethnic literature, Bengali literature, Hindi literature, or English literature. We have heard the name of William Shakespeare, okay, because William Shakespeare is a very great writer. That's why this Wolf personally thinks that he is one of the greatest writers, and that's why she has taken this example. Okay, why she has taken this example? Because she personally thinks that he is one of the greatest writers, and all of us, like most of the people believe that William Shakespeare is a great writer, and that's why she is giving this. She has invented this imaginary character. She has invented this imaginary character of William Shakespeare's imaginary sister, who is gifted as Shakespeare. Everyone says that Shakespeare is a very good writer. He is very talented, and he is a magnificent writer. And we always think the brothers and sisters and siblings have that connection. If one sibling is good in writing, the another sibling will be good in writing, because they will have the same kind of parenting and all that. And that's why people just think that. But the thing is that in that age, if Shakespeare has a sister, okay, what would have happened to her? And all these things she has discussed in this very text. Let me just elaborate. To illustrate this, she offers the example of a hypothetical gifted but uneducated sister of William Shakespeare. She is uneducated. If there was an imaginary sister, if there were an imaginary sister of Shakespeare, she was uneducated, because education was not given to women at that point of time. Education was not accessible to women. It was only given to men. And then, and she was disgraced from all but the most mundane domestic values, eventually kills herself, because she has so many talent, and she also wanted to write, but she could not. Her society, her father, her surroundings didn't allow her to fulfill her wishes, and finally she commits suicide. If there was an imaginary sister, and that would have been the fate of Shakespeare's sister. Okay. So now, eventually, Keats says, Wolf celebrates the works of women who have overcome that tradition. So, but some of the women have overcome the tradition and become writers, including Jane Austen, George Eliot, and the Bronte sisters. One of you have said that your favorite writer is Bronte sister, and they have just overcome those limitations, and they have started writing in that very age. So Bronte sister Anne, Charlotte, and Emily. In the final section, Wolf suggests that great minds are androgynous. She argues that intellectual freedom requires financial freedom, and she entreats her audience to write not only fiction but poetry, criticism, and scholarly works as well. So basically, Wolf has written this, has delivered these two lectures and published it in a book form or text form or in an essay form, because she wanted to promote financial independence of women, and especially wanted women to write more and more. And she has appreciated various women writers who have been writing in that age. And she is also appealing that through via this text that everyone should write. Women should write. And for that, whatever the things she has to do as a woman, she has to do all these things. She has been given some description in that very text. And that's why I have asked you, because because sometimes the when a girl child is born in a house, in a home, at a home, they basically treat the brother and sister are not treated equally most of the times. Okay, no, in I'm not telling it that in your case it has been happening, but it has been, we cannot deny that it has not been happening. Most of the time the male child has been given more rights, more means everything he'll be getting more, and the sister or the girl child will be given like she has to, you can complete your education for a point limited, you will get limited education after that, all you have to do is to get married. And that's why I have asked you about your ambition, because you have to have one ambition for yourself. You just can't study and then get married and have children. That is not bad. But the thing is that as you have come to study to the college, you have to have some aim. You cannot just roam around and have your graduation certificate and then get married. Don't do this. Okay. And that's why I have asked about your aim. Because this piece, she just want to promote that as a woman, you have to overcome all your difficulties and you have to choose a career, build a career for yourself. And you have to, for that, you have to financially independent. Okay. Okay, if you have understood, then please raise your hand. It's very difficult to like talk in a Zoom call because I cannot see anyone. If you have understand, you have understood anything, then please raise your hand. It will be helpful for me to continue. Please, okay, thank you. Okay. So you have understood these points. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. So let me go to the second point. Okay. Second point, that is symbols, the various symbols she has used in this text. Okay. Let me switch to the next topic. Next topic means next section. So, okay, again, I have to ask one question and you have to answer, like voluntarily you will answer. Okay, I won't force you. I will explain the things because I am here to help you. No, so I have already done my research and all. I am here to help you, but I also want some input from you. So, the title, the very title, what is the title of the text that we are discussing today? It is A Room of One's Own. So, what do you mean by room? Just tell me, what do you mean by the whole title of this text? What do you, have you understood anything by the A Room of One's Own? Please raise your hand. Anything? Okomete kolo ma buzi pao. A Room of One's Own. Itu meaning to koba mo. Kunda answer kori ba niki tu. Korele kori dia? Raise eta to hand raise hoye ache. কবা নেকি তুমি কি বুঝি পাইছা যে এ রুম অফ ওয়ান সোন ওকে রেজ ইয়োর হ্যান্ড এন্ড সে টক ইটস নট দ্যাট ইউ হ্যাভ টু টেক্সট হিয়ার আই ওয়ান্ট ইউ টু টক আই রিয়েলি ডোন্ট লাইক দিস ইটস লাইক এ লাইক লাইক দিস ভেরি মাচ ইউ নো ক্লোজ স্পেস আই ডোন্ট লাইক ইট আই লাইক ক্লাসরুম লেকচারস প্লিজ প্লিজ টক এনিওয়ান হু ওয়ান্টস টু আনসার প্লিজ টক Unmute yourself and talk. Anyone who wants to answer that, what do you understand by a room of one's own? A room of one's own, what do you understand by that? Anyone? Ki baat bujhi paisa no? A room of one's own.
Private space.
Okay. Thank you. Anyone else? Anyone else, please? এইটো চিম্পল কথা এ ৰুম অফ ওৱান চন এইটো তুমি বেছিকেলি কি বুজি পোৱা এইটো 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 কোৱাৰ পিছতে কি বুজি পাইছা হোৱাট হেভ ইউ আণ্ডাৰষ্টুড কোৱা এ ৰুম অফ ওৱান চন চিম্পল এ ৰুম অফ ওৱান চন
ৰুম অফ ওৱান চন ৰেফাৰ্ছ টু এজ আমাৰ এইটো প্ৰাইভেট প্লেচ হয় হুৱেৰ উই কেন ডু এভৰিথিং ইন টু আৰ অ'ন ফ্ৰীডম মানে আমাৰ যি মন যায় আমি সেইটো কৰিব পাৰোঁ
পাৰ্চনেল স্পেচৰ কথা কৈছা ন এনিৱান এলচ থেংক ইউ এনিৱান এলচ কোৱা কথা পাতা
ম্যাম এই রুম অফ ওয়ানস ওন যেটো কইছে মানে ফ্রিডম টু কথাও জড়িত হইছে আর ওনারশিপৰ কথাটো জড়িত হইছে
অ অ অ অ অ নাও ইয়া টকিং ওনারশিপ জড়িত হইছে তার প্রাইভেট স্পেস দুজনে কলা আর তুমি কলা ওনারশিপ ওকে এনিওয়ান এলস কথা পাতা মো কথা পাতি ভাল পোৱা মানুহ দেই অলপ কথা উত্তর পাতা এই মুখ বন্ধ করে থাকলে কেন গম পাম কি বুঝি পাইছে না না পাওয়া
ম্যাম রুম হলে মানে নিজৰ যেটো ৰুমৰ কথা কৈছে সেইটো ৰুমত নিজৰ সকলোবিলাক কথা মানে নিজে খুলি মানে চাব পাৰে স্বাধীনতা এটা থাকে লগতে মানে নিজৰ মানে ডাবল ষ্টেণ্ডাৰ্ডটো তাত নাথাকে মানে নিজে যেনেকে নিজক ভাল পায় সেইটো মানে নিজে কৰিব পাৰে
ওকে মানে
প্ৰাইভেট স্পেচ হয়
প্ৰাইভেট স্পেচ হয় এজনে তুমি তিনজনে কলা প্ৰাইভেট স্পেচ আৰু এজনী কলে যে প্ৰাইভেট স্পেচ আৰু ওনাৰশ্বিপ ওকে anyone else
ma'am a room of one's own means our own space like every individual should have their own space irrespective of their male or female and okay. Like a female should have like financial independence or money to have a room to have her own room so she can write in her room
okay okay
যিহেতু বুক খনত মানে ৰাইটাৰ্চ খিনি কথা কোৱা হৈছে বা ফিমেল ৰাইটাৰ্চ খিনিক বিশেষকে মানে বিশেষকে ধৰা হৈছে ছাবজেক্ট হিচাপে গতিকে মানে যেনেদৰে প্ৰতিটো কামৰ কাৰণে নিৰ্দিষ্ট একোটা স্পেচ থাকে এতিয়া কিবা এটা গান বনাবলৈ বা মিউজিক কৰিবৰ কাৰণে নিৰ্দিষ্ট এটা ষ্টুডিঅ' থাকে আৰু কিবা আৰ্ট কৰিবৰ কাৰণেও এটা ষ্টুডিঅ' থাকে কিন্তু ঠিক মানে তেনেদৰে সেই লিখা কামটোৰ কাৰণেও এটা পাৰ্চনেল স্পেচ লাগে কাৰণ যিহেতু লিখাটো এটা ক্ৰিয়েটিভিটি আৰু আপুনি বহুত চিঞৰ বাখৰৰ মাজত এখন ধৰি লওক যুদ্ধৰ কথা বৰ্ণনা কৰিব নোৱাৰে বা এটা খুব মানে কোলাহলৰ মাজত প্ৰকৃতিৰ নিৰৱতাৰ কথাটো ক'ব মানে লিখিব নোৱাৰে কিন্তু যেতিয়া আপোনাৰ সেই নিজৰ স্পেচটো থাকে কিবা এটা ক্ৰিয়েট কৰিবৰ কাৰণে তেতিয়া মানে সেইটো পাৰ্চপেক্টিভ যদি চোৱা হয় তেতিয়াহ'লে সেই ৰুম অফ ওৱানছ অ'ন বুলি মানে কোৱা হৈছে
আচ্ছা অ'কে থেংক ইউ সো নাও লেট মি আস্ক ওৱান মোৰ কুৱেশ্যন ডু উইমেন নীড দেয়াৰ অ'ন স্পেচ
ইয়েছ মেম
Yes, ma'am. Yes. How many years? Total 62 yes, plus students are there. How many years are there? Do women need space of their own? How many years? Hey, kotha pata de message koribo na lage etia.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Saita pasta hol.
Yes, ma'am.
Sata hol aru. মই কাউণ্ট কৰি আছো দেই ছেভেন এইট নাইন টেন
ইয়েছ মেম
আচ্ছা কোনোবা নো আছে নেকি মই গম পালো কোনোবা নো আছে নেকি যে আমাৰ স্পেচ নালাগে আমি ছোৱালী মানুহ আমি মাইকী মানুহ আমাৰ স্পেচ নালাগে এনেকুৱা কোনো আছে নেকি যে আমাৰ স্পেচ নালাগে উইমেন ডোণ্ট নিড দেয়াৰ অ'ন স্পেচ আছে নেকি কোনোবাৰ এনে বক্তব্য অপিনিয়ন মোৰ অসমীয়াটো ইমান ভাল নহয় দেই অলপ মানে বুজি পালে হ'ল মই শিকি আছো লাহে ধীৰেকে কাৰো কিবা অপিনিয়ন আছে নেকি যে মানে আমাৰ স্পেচ নালাগে আমি ছোৱালী মানুহ আমাৰ স্পেচ নালাগে কোৱালিটিও আমাৰ স্পেচ লাগে চবেই এগ্ৰি কৰিলে যে আমাৰ উইমেন ডু নিড স্পেচ দেন হোৱাই ডু উই নিড স্পেচ কেন এনিৱান টেল মি Why do we need space?
Ma'am, to explore our own thinking.
To explore mm-hmm. our own thinking.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Acha, etia thik ase ha tumaloke beano paba mo alok question ma dilo so de tumaloke ghorote sobar ki nijer eta personal room ase neki to laaj lagibo eko nai tumar ghorote sobar eta personal room ase মাৰ লগতে শ্বেয়াৰ কৰা
আছে
সবাৰ আছে নেকি মানুহতে শেয়ার নকৰা নেকি সবৰ পাৰ্সনেল ৰুম আছে
সামটাইম
মানে তোমাৰ এটা এক্সট্ৰা ৰুম আছে এতিয়ালৈকে দি দিছে কেতিয়া দিলে মানে গ্ৰেজুৱেচনৰ পৰা দিলে না আৰু সৰু থাকোঁতে দিলে
No, ma'am. After HS.
Listen to me first of all. That feminism or gender studies is not about a theory. It's our life. Whatever we experience, all these things are discussed in these theories. Okay, this is our life. This is not something that's theory you have to study and all this. That's why I'm asking. If do you have your own space at home? Sobar room ase nije. Huh? সবর নিজে নিজে ঘরতে রুম আছে সবর আছে মার লগতে শেয়ার নকৰা নেকি না নিজের রুম আছে পড়া যেতিয়া পড়া শোনা করা রুম তো দুয়ার তো মারিবলে দিয়ে না নাই
নাই রুমৰ দুয়ার নামারো মানে এনে ওপেন থাকে বাট এটা পার্সোনাল রুম আছে যত মানে নিজৰ ওন স্পেস এটা পাও কেতিয়াবা মাকো কওঁ যে মোৰ লগত শুবলে বাট সামটাইমস মানে সদায় নহয়
সদায় নহয় ন আৰু ৰুমটো কেতিয়াবা দুৱাৰ চোৱা মাৰিব দিয়ে নেকি ঘৰতে
নাই মই নিজৰ পৰা তেনেকে কেতিয়াও তেনেকে মৰা নাই খোলাই থাকে ৰুমটো থাকো বাট খোলা থাকে ওপেন থাকে
আচ্ছা যেতিয়া তুমি পঢ়া শুনা কৰা তেতিয়া কেতিয়াবা ডিষ্টাৰ্ব ফিল হয় নেকি
নহয় ঘৰত তেনেকে কোনো নাথাকে তো কেতিয়াবা এটা হত থাকিলেও তেনেকে ডিষ্টাৰ্ব ফিল নহয়
তুমি কোৱা মই শুনিছো মই অলপ পানী Feminism is not all about beating the like other women with the stick, okay? It's all about the like accepting every woman as they are. Kompala je feminism boli je tai tenekoi koribo likbo. Tai salwar pindhilo tai feminist hobo pare, tai miniskirt pindhilo tai feminist hobo pare. Feminism is all about respecting every woman choices, okay? হে কারণে তোমার রুম দুয়ারটু খোলা রাখি তুমি লিখিব পারা তেনে কোনো প্রবলেম নাই কিয় মানে ইয়াতে মই এটু কনটেক্সট কইছো যে তোমার পার্সোনাল লাইফে মই ইনভাইট করিবলৈ নাই যোৱা কথাটো হল ইয়াতে আমার বেসিক্যালি থিমস আছে ইন্টারাপশনস গম্পালা হে কারণে মই এবুর কোয়েশ্চন খুদি আছো হ্যাঁ মানে একদম তোমার লোকৰ পার্সোনাল স্পেস ইনভাইট করিবলৈ একদম মন নাই মই খালি কনটেক্সট এবুর কথা খুদি আছো আৰু এটা কথা হল তোমালোকে যেতিয়া লিখা মেলা কৰে তোমালোকে ডিস্টার্ব নহওয়া তেনে এইটো ঠিক আছে কোনো প্ৰব্লেম নাই তোমালোকে লিখা মেলা কৰা তো এতিয়া মই আনচাৰটো পাই গ'লো এতিয়া মই চিম্বলছ এ ৰুম অফ ওৱান চল কেনেকুৱা এটা উল্ফে কেনেকুৱা চিম্বল হিচাপে ইউজ কৰিছে মই এইটো কৈ আছো ঠিক আছে লেট মি ষ্টাৰ্ট দ্য চেণ্ট্ৰেল পইণ্ট অফ এ ৰুম অফ ওৱান চল ইজ দেট এভৰি ওমেন নিডছ এ ৰুম অফ আৰ অ'ন চ' বেচিকেলি উল্ফ বিলিভছ দেট এভৰি ওমেন নিডছ এ ৰুম অফ আৰ অ'ন something men are able to enjoy without question ei room tu je eta lora khodai dewa hoy kintu khodai ekta swali manuk ba mike manik dewa no hoy tak share kori bolo koa hoy keta tumi malogote thaka enko koa hoy tumaloko koa hoa nai etu phal kota we living in 21st century kintu agote enko hoisile lora boli tak space dewa hoy kintu swali manue ba mike manue room tu dewa hoa nai mane thik ase hei karone সো তাই কৈছে যে অলফে কি কৈছে সামথিং মেন আর এবল টু এনজয় উইদাউট কোয়েশ্চন এ রুম অফ হার ওন উড প্রোভাইড এ ওমেন উইথ দ্য টাইম এন্ড দ্য স্পেস টু এঙ্গেজ ইন আন ইন্টারাপ্টেড রাইটিং টাইম সো হোয়াই ডু ইউ দ্য উলফ কি কথা উলফের বক্তব্যটা কি অপিনিয়ন দেখি যে উলফ ওয়ান্টেড টু টেল দ্যাট ওয়ান্টেড টু সে দ্যাট দ্যাট ইফ এ ওমেন ওয়ান্ট টু রাইট সামথিং ইন্ডিপেন্ডেন্টলি ইফ শি হ্যাজ টু হ্যাজ হার ওন রুম এন্ড স্পেস and via room and space only she can write something good during old time women rarely enjoyed these luxuries they remained elusive to women and as a result their art suffered but Wolf is concerned with more than just the room itself okay, she is concerned just the room itself, because she is her like main argument was that if a woman has to write one fiction, she needs her own room and space. Okay, now she is telling that it is also the symbol for so many things. A room of one's own, it is also the symbol for so many things. Then what are these things? Wolf uses the room as a symbol for many larger issues, such as privacy. Everyone needs privacy. Okay, whether irrespective of their sex, irrespective of their gender, every human being needs space. That's it. Period. Okay, everyone needs, whether she is a man, whether she is a the person is a male or female, everyone just needs a space of their own, such as privacy. Then leisure time. Okay, most of the time the thing is that women has to perform so many duties. Okay, so let me ask another question. How many of you know how to cook?
সবে
পারা নাকি রন্ধা বাড়া করবো মেম?
সবে
পারা? কেতিয়াবা মোক ইয়ে করবা দে, ইনভাইট করবা দে, তেনে ভাল রন্ধা বাড়া করবলে জানলে। মই গোলাঘাট গৈ থাকো, তুমি জানা চাগে, তোমালোকে জানা চাগে, তো সেইকাৰণে মোক কবাৰ ইনভাইট কৰি লবা। সবাই ৰন্ধা বঢ়া জানা ন?
নাজানো মেম।
নো মেম, জানো নাজানো।
মানে সব জানিব নালাগে, মানে এনে দাল ভাত এনেকুৱা ৰান্ধিব জানা নেকি?
নাজানো মেম,
কৰকুৰা বস্তুবো জানো।
কেনেকুৱা কি বস্তু
মানে যোনবোৰ ইজি হয় বনাব, তেনেকুৱাবোৰহে জানো
বেছি। দাল ভাত ৰান্ধিব পাৰিলে হয়, খাব পাৰিলে হব মানে। আৰু যেতিয়া মাছ কৰিব জেগা খাব, ৰন্ধা বঢ়া জানিলে ভাল আকৌ। সেইকাৰণে অলপ ৰন্ধা বঢ়া চবে জানা না। আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, কাম টু দ্য পইণ্ট। দ্য থিং ইজ দেট তোমালোকে যে ৰন্ধা বঢ়া জানা, কেতিয়াবা তোমাৰ মায়ে মাতে নেকি ৰন্ধা বঢ়া হেল্প কৰিবলৈ? পৰি আছা ন, ৰাতিপুৱাৰ পৰা পৰি আছে, কেতিয়াবা মাতে নেকি অলপ হেল্প কৰি যোৱা?
Yes ma'am.
মাতে নেকি? সবকে মাতে? মায়ে অলপ অলপ হেল্প কৰি যাব, পঢ়া শুনা অলপ কৰি থাকিব। ফ্ৰী থাকিলে মানে পঢ়া শুনা যেতিয়া কৰি আছে তেতিয়া নামাতে ন?
তেতিয়া নামাতে।
অ, তেতিয়া পঢ়া শুনা কৰি থাকে। বৰ ভাল দেই, তোমালোকে বৰ ভাল ভাল ইয়ে কৰি আছা দেই। তো সবে তোমালোকে নামাতে ন? মাকটো হেল্প কৰিবই লাগে ন? আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে, মই এইটো কুৱেশ্যন কিয় সুধিলো, মই এইটো আই এম কামিং টু দ্য পইণ্ট। অ'কে, সো দ্য থিং ইজ দেট উই নিড লেজাৰ টাইম। তুমি গোটেই দিন যদি কাম কৰি থাকা তেতিয়া তুমি লেজাৰ টাইমেই নাপাবা ন? তেতিয়া তুমি লিখা মেলা কেনেকৈ কৰিবা? তুমি গোটেই দিন যদি কাম কৰি থাকা, ঠিক ন? হয়নে না? হেল্ল'
ইয়েছ মেম,
ইয়েছ মেম,
উই নিড টাইম, উই নিড লেজাৰ টাইম। তুমি অলপ বহি থাকিব লাগিবতো, লিখা মেলা কৰিবলৈ অলপ টাইম পাব লাগিব। তুমি গোটেই দিন বিজি থাকিবা, কাম কৰিবা, কেনেকুৱা লিখা মেলা কৰিবা, হয়নে? এইটো হ'ল তাইৰ অপিনিয়নটো, এইটোৱেই হ'ল। দ্য ৰুম অলছ' ষ্টেণ্ডছ ফৰ, ৰুম ইজ এ চিম্বল অফ such as privacy, then leisure time, and financial independence. Okay, if you need your own space, you have to be financially independent. If you want to have your, if you want to build your own house, you have to be financially independent. Okay, if you earn, then you can have your, or you can build your own house, and you can have all the freedom and leisure time to write, to create anything good. Now, another thing, that financial independence, first one is privacy, then second one is leisure time, and the third one is financial independence. These are the things also stand for this, a room of one's own. Okay, it doesn't mean just privacy, it also means leisure time and financial independence. And each of which is an essential component of the countless inequalities between men and women. Wolf predicts that until these inequalities are rectified, women will remain second-class citizens, and their literary achievements will also be branded as such. If the basic necessities are not met, okay, then a woman can never write. So before that, before if you blame women that they cannot produce great literature like Shakespeare, like Chaucer, like Wordsworth, like Keats, then you have to just go through, you have to see all these conditions that have been, women have been deprived throughout the ages, okay. So now let me, there may be some time constraint, so let me go to the this analysis of the text, okay. I have discussed the introduction point, I have discussed, then I have discussed the setting of the text, then I have discussed the symbols. Now let me discuss analysis, let me give you a brief analysis of the text. So the in her highly influential critical essay A Room of One's Own, that was written in 1929, Virginia Woolf studied the cultural, economical, and educational disabilities within the patriarchal system that prevent women from realizing their creative potential. So, can anyone tell me what is patriarchy? Hope you know by this time. What is patriarchy?
Ma'am, male patriarchal society is used for a society where male are getting more privileges and playing a dominant role.
Okay. Anyone else wants to participate? What is patriarchy?
A male-dominated society.
Bhalke go, bhalke. A male-dominated society. That is called patriarchy. No, this is the system of society that is male-dominated. Okay. Anything? Anyone else? Patriarchy is a system of society where male, especially heterosexual male, okay, there are so many like sexualities are there and so many sects of male are also there, okay. The heterosexual alpha male are given all the rights, most of the rights, they enjoy most of the rights, and the other, the like other, especially the other means especially the second sex, that is the women, okay, the female kind. They were dominated by them because they were treated as second class citizen. Okay, that is, that system is called patriarchy. So in this patriarchal system, Woolf studied the cultural, economical, and educational disabilities within the patriarchal system. What are the differences that is given? That is, what are the opportunities that are given to men and women? All these things are discussed by Virginia Woolf in this very text or essay, that is A Room of One's Own, within the patriarchal system that prevent women from realizing their creative potential. Okay, in a patriarchal society, in most of in a patriarchal, still now, okay, in patriarchal society, women are what are the rights a woman should means basically what are the things that are expected from a woman? You get your education, like a little bit of education you need, that is for sure, I think. That is the there is a term called this prize wife. Okay, prize wife, like she has to be beautiful, she has to be a little bit educated, not more educated than the husband, but she has to be educated, because that is a like trophy wife. Okay, that is called the trophy wife, and that's why you need a like, little bit of education but less than your husband. Okay, so patriarchal system that prevent women from realizing their creative potential with her imaginary character Judith, that is Shakespeare. Again, she is telling them, because I'm analyzing the text again, that's why I have to bring the character again. Okay, that is Shakespeare's fictional sister. She illustrated that, she means Woolf illustrated that a woman with Shakespeare's faculties would have been denied the opportunities, would have been denied if Shakespeare had a sister, she would have been denied the opportunities that Shakespeare enjoyed. Okay, Shakespeare, whenever he used to write, people used to like go gaga over whatever he was writing. Okay, like they were just, you were writing so good, and he was so much encouraged, and he was given so many opportunities to write. But if he had a sister, what would have been the fate she has discussed in this text? Shakespeare faculties would have been denied the opportunities that Shakespeare enjoyed. Examining the careers and works of women authors like Ephra Behn, Jane Austen, George Eliot, and the Bronte sister, Woolf argued that the patriarchal education system and reading practices conditioned to use an to use women to read from men's point of view. Okay, the kind of education we have in a patriarchal system, that is very important. That is, we only know the man's point of view. Okay, everything is given from the alpha male's point of view. Not all kind of men, especially the alpha male. Okay, the alpha heterosexual male. From their point of view, all these things are given. Women to read from men's point of view and make them internalize the aesthetic and literary values adopted by male authors and critics within the patriarchal system, wherein these values, although male-centered, are assumed and promoted as universal. So whatever the man is thinking, whatever the man in plural or in singular, man is thinking or men are thinking, all are treated as universal, that these things are the ultimate truth. No one's point of view has been taken, okay, have never been taken, but whatever the male will be saying, that will be the ultimate truth. And that's why these things are, we all have said that Shakespeare's writing has universal appeal. Okay, so whatever the male will be writing, because women are not writing, they are not given chance either. Okay, nobody will be talking about that. But whatever the male will be writing, that will be taken as the standard form, as taken as universal. It is in this work that Wolff suggested that language is gendered. Okay, that is very much interesting. Okay, the language we use, we always use he instead of she. That is an example. Okay, we always use mankind to refer to the like all the humankind. We use the word mankind, but we never use womankind. This is also the example of the language, the patriarchal language we use. Okay, so you have to change it. You can definitely change it. Whenever I write something, I usually word the word she instead of he. We can always start the change. Okay, and even the writer Amartya Sen, who has got Nobel Prize in economics, he has written a fiction too. And in his book, he has written whatever he was writing, instead of he used she. Okay, so you can also use she instead of he if you want to change the language. Okay, because all this is an example of gendered language or sexist language. Devage and argued that the women author, having no other language at her command, is forced to use the sexist masculine language. This is the masculine language. This is not the feminine language. So, okay, there are many various experiences, female experiences. For that, we need feminine language. Okay, and that's why we need more and more female writers. Wolff also realized the need for a narrative form to capture the fluid, incoherent female experiences. For writing female experiences, we need a more fluid and feminine kind of language. Okay, she has suggested, not me, Wolff has suggested in that very text. Now, they defy order and relativity. Okay, that defy order and rationality, and hence her employment of that stream of consciousness technique in her novels, capturing the lives of Mrs. Dalloway, Mrs. Ramsay, and so on, inspired by the psychological theories of Carl Wolff, also proposed the concept of the androgynous creative mind, which she fictionalized through Orlando in an attempt to go beyond the male-female binary. Okay, so Wolff also suggested that we have to use, for defining, for describing female experiences, we need a language which defies the normal rules, that is the patriarchal rules in writing. We need a new kind of language, and that's why she has been writing her novels in the stream of consciousness technique. So can anyone tell me what is stream of consciousness technique? Because you have already reached fifth semester, that's why I can ask that question. Can anyone tell me what is stream of consciousness technique? Maybe a bit tough. But can anyone please tell me what is stream of consciousness technique?
Yes, ma'am. It is a technique employed in literary works that says that our mind is like a
river, stream.
Which flows ইয়াতে ষ্ট্ৰীম অফ কনচিয়াছনেছ টেকনিকত কি হয় মানে মনৰ যিটো ইণ্টেৰিয়ৰ মনোলগ সেইটো প্ৰকাশ কৰা হয়
because we don't think logically. Okay, whatever comes to, we think like illogically. Okay, there is no there is no connection of thoughts. Whenever we think illogically, and there is no connection, and that's why we need different technique to express our views, and that's why Wolfes use stream of consciousness technique. Okay, there may be some time constraint, that's why I'm going to the themes. Okay, so there are various themes in this text, so let me choose some themes and let me discuss. Okay, like, because there will be some time constraint, I think. Post is there or not, I don't know. Is there will be some time, can I have some more time? Hello.
Yes ma'am.
Okay, thank you very much. So let me discuss the various themes. Okay, the various themes that has been discussed in Wolfes, A Room of One's Own. First one is gender inequality. So can anyone tell me what is gender inequality? By this time you should know, otherwise I'll explain. There is no problem. Can anyone tell me what is gender inequality? Please raise your hand and answer. Gender inequality. Anyone? One or two lines. What is gender inequality?
Gender inequality means when women and men are not given the same equal opportunities.
Okay, very nice. Excellent. Anything else? Anyone else wants to answer that question? What is gender inequality? More or less, let me explain then. Gender inequality is like, there are two set of rules for men and women. Women and men, they are bound by two different set of rules. Okay. Women are given, they have been a path that you have to follow, otherwise you will be given names, various names. So that is gender equality. Men and women are never given equal opportunities. It is the tip of the iceberg. Okay. Now let me explain how Wolf has explained in her essay, A Room of One's Own, gender inequality. Throughout A Room of One's Own, the narrator emphasizes the fact that women are treated unequally in the society. Isn't it? We all agree. I think we all agree. Okay. Anyone who doesn't agree, you can raise your hand. Okay. We all agree that women are treated, just because we are women, we are treated differently. We are treated differently by the society, isn't it? Can anyone give me one example of that? Can anyone give an example of gender inequality, that men and women are not treated equally? One simple example, or any discrimination you have like experienced in your life, anyone? Just because you are a girl, that's why you are given, like, you are treated differently in any situation. Can anyone give me one example of that? You are already adult now, you have plenty of examples like that.
Ma'am, in domestic life, the girls are generally asked to learn cooking, but boys are not taught how to cook.
Cook. Okay. Anyone else? Can anyone else give another example?
Women are not allowed to go outdoors মানে at a limited time মানে থাকে যো women আপ মানে বাহার যাব নি দিয়ে
বালকে নি দিয়ে মুকো নি দিব কোয়া তারপর
ম্যাম in terms of writing men are given more preference than women
in terms of writing. It says that if someone chooses to be a writer, men will be given more preference. Yes, that is job preference. Excellent, excellent. Anyone else? You are full of ideas. I really like, I'm just liking the class, the session actually. You all are full of ideas. Anything else? Anyone like to like say or share your experience? One of the experience that only female or the women have to go through, but men never have to. I'm talking in plural terms actually. Anything, any more, anything? First, the first answer you have given that someone has given, that is cooking. Cooking is a life skill. Everyone should learn to cook, whether irrespective of their gender. Anything else?
Ma'am, well behave korbo kwa hoy as a ami girl to swale manu ke bhal behave korbi lora manu ketu kotha
o bale ke bhal behave kora lora ketia ebu hikabolo na lage mane e nikay amar society eto jano aru jeta ene eta experience kwa jitu mane school e swale manu pora hoy tumar lokor e je aru lora ketu ketia mane hioti etu experience nai aru tumaloke jeta moi koy disu মই কৈ দিছো যেতিয়া তোমালোকে কলেজত আহা ঠিক আছে তোমালোকৰ যে ইটিজিং হয় নাই ৰিচেণ্টলি এটা ইনচিডেণ্ট হৈ গ'ল হ'ল নহয় শৰ্মাৰ ইনচিডেণ্টটো জানা নহয় তাই যে ছোৱালীজনী শুনিছা নহয় ইটিজিং ইনচিডেণ্টটো ইটিজিং মানে মাৰি পেলালে যে এইটো এটা ইনচিডেণ্ট মই নামটো এতিয়া মানে মনত পৰা নাই মই পাহৰি গৈছো মানে নামটো কি শৰ্মা আছিলে তো কথাটো হ'ল যে ইটিজিং যে ইটিজিং যে কথাটো আছে ন এইটো ছোৱালী মানুহে ফিল কৰে ল'ৰাকতো আমি কেতিয়াবা এইবোৰ ৰাস্তা ঘাটে ওলাই গ'লে আমি কি কৈ থাকো কি চিটি চিটি মাৰো নেকি কেতিয়াবা মাৰা নেকি তোমালোকে ল'ৰা জোকাও নেকি কিন্তু তোমালোকতে এনেকুৱা হয় না ন তোমালোকতে এনেকুৱা হয় না ন দিছ ইজ এ ভেৰি প্ৰমিনেণ্ট প্ৰব্লেম ইউ ন' দেট কিন্তু তোমালোকে যেতিয়া ল'ৰা জোকাই ল'ৰাক তোমালোকে ল'ৰা নজোকা যেতিয়া তোমালোকে এনেকুৱা ইফটিজিং হয় তোমালোকৰ লগত তোমালোকে ঘৰত গৈ কোৱা না নাই ঘৰত গৈ কোৱা নেকি কোৱা খুলি কথা পাতে একো ন মই ছোৱালী মানুহ মই জানো এইবোৰ মাইকী মানুহ একচুৱেলি
ৰাস্তাতে গালি পাৰো কেতিয়াবা
নহয় তোমালোকে যেতিয়া ল'ৰা কিবা এটা ক'লে ন তোমালোকে ল'ৰা এটা কিবা কিবি বেয়া এটা কমেণ্ট কৰিলে ঘৰত গৈ কোৱা বা টিচাৰক কোৱা নেকি ঘৰত গৈ কোৱা ঘৰতে কি কোনোবা নকোৱা নেকি কোৱা কোৱা কথা পাতা তোমালোকে এইটো এটা জেনুইন প্ৰব্লেম কেনেকৈ হেণ্ডেল কৰিব লাগে মই কৈ দিম তোমালোকে ঘৰত কোৱা নাই কথাটো হেল্ল' এবাৰ অডিব তোমালোকৰ ঘৰতে কোৱা না না কথাটো যে তোমালোকে ল'ৰা জোকা ল'ৰা তোমালোকে বেড বেড কমেণ্ট কৰি আছে যেতিয়া তুমি কলেজত যোৱা কোনোবা নকোৱা নেকি চবে কোৱা নেকি ঘৰত গৈ ঘৰত এইটো কেনেকুৱা ঘৰত এইটো কেনেকুৱা ৰিয়েকশ্যন থাকে
কয় নেক্সট টাইমৰ পৰা ইগনোৰ কৰিবলৈ জাস্ট এবোৰ মাইণ্ডত
নানিবলৈ আৰু 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 কেইটামান কোৱা মানে কেইজনে কোৱা আৰু কি এজনী ক'লা যে তোমাৰ ঘৰতে কোৱা কিন্তু কয় ইগনোৰ কৰি দিবলৈ ন তাৰপিছত এইটো এটা প্ৰমিনেণ্ট প্ৰব্লেম দেট উই ফেচ ইটিজিং পিপল থিংক দেট ইজ নট হাৰ্মফুল দেট কজ মেনি কাইণ্ড অফ মেণ্টেল প্ৰব্লেমছ Recently, I have done one training on mental illness. So I know this kind of things actually seriously create problems. And extremely, you have seen that recently, that incident of that girl, that she has been killed or rather butchered. Anyone else? এইটোৱে মই ভাবিবলৈ খুজিছিলো বিচাৰিছিলো কথাটো হ'ল যেতিয়া তুমি ঘৰত গৈ ক'বা কেতিয়াবা তোমাকে ব্লেম কৰিব যে তুমি কিবা কৰিছা Mambala, there are many people who have blamed that girl that who has been butchered, especially female. Female, like female also blame that very girl. So whenever these kind of things happen, you have to tell your parents and you have to make them conscious that is not your fault. And that is, you have to take protection from that because that can be harmful sometimes. And one of the incidents we have seen, isn't it? So we have to talk about these things. You can make your mother understand. She will understand because when she was young, she has to go through the same thing. She has gone through the same thing, isn't it? Isn't it? You never think that just because you are beautiful, they are teasing you. That is not the thing. You have to ask for help. You have to tell your parents, convince your parents that is your not fault. That is not your fault. You are not doing anything wrong. Okay. Let me come to the point again. Throughout A Room of One's Own, the narrator emphasizes the fact that women are treated unequally in the society and that is why they have produced less impressive works of literature than men. To illustrate her point, the narrator creates a woman named Judith Shakespeare, the imaginary twin sister. I think I have already discussed that. Judiths are underestimated and explicitly de-emphasized. That is the thing that just you have told. That when a woman want to write that Judith, that imaginary sister of Shakespeare, when she wanted to write, she told her parents and surroundings, and they were just like, why do you need to write? You don't need to write. You just get prepared for getting married. And when she refused to get married, she was beaten by her father. All these things have been discussed in this text. Okay, she has been beaten by her father, and finally she commits suicide. And that is the fate of a woman who was as gifted as Shakespeare, one of the greatest prominent writer, isn't it, playwright. Judith writes, but she is secretive and ashamed of it. She is engaged at a fairly young age. When she begs not to get married, her father beats her. She eventually commits suicide. The narrator invents the tragic figure of Judith to prove that a woman as talented as Shakespeare could never have achieved such success. Talent is an essential component of Shakespeare's success. But because women are treated so differently, a female Shakespeare would have treated quite differently, even if she would have as much talent as Shakespeare. And that is the thing. That his sister, okay, his imaginary sister, Judith Shakespeare, if she has she was as gifted as him, but she would have never given those opportunities that were assigned to him. Okay, and that's why she could never write, and finally she would have committed suicide because she would have gone mad. When she wants to write but she can't, so that will give her some mental problems, and finally she has committed suicide. That is a result of mental illness. If you ever got to know about this mental illness, you will got to know that suicide is one of the outcome of mental illness. Now the another theme that I'm going to discuss today is the importance of money that has been discussed by Wolf in A Room of One's Own. For the narrator of A Room of One's Own, money is the primary element that prevents women from having a room of their own, and thus having money is one of the utmost importance. Because women do not have power. Okay, they don't have power. Power means also political power. Their creativity has been systematically stifled throughout the ages. Systematically done. Women writers were erased systematically. Okay, there was no sign of women writers in Wolf was writing. There were very few women writers were there. And the narrator writes, intellectual freedom depends upon material things. If you want to write, you need a room, and for that you need money. That is the importance of money. Poetry demands upon intellectual freedom, and women have always been poor. Women were always been poor. They have to be stay at home, they have to be at home. So how can they earn? And that's why they have been poor throughout the ages, not for like 200 years, but they have been poor from the beginning of time. She uses this quotation to explain why so few women have written successful poetry. She believes that the writing of novels lends itself more easily to frequent starts and stops, so women are more likely to write novels than poetry. She has also pointed out that for writing poetry, okay, for writing poetry, you need like one flow of thought. And that's why it is very much difficult for a woman, because she will be interrupted, she has to perform so many duties. That's why she can't write poetry. But she can opt for fiction writing, because you can start and stop, then change it. Okay, there are so many, if you give like pause, then also you can complete a fiction. But you, for that is, we have learned that overflow of emotion and tranquility and spontaneity, all these things are needed for writing poetry. But for writing fiction, you can start and stop. And that's why women can opt for writing, at least they can opt for writing fiction. Women must contend with frequent interruptions because they are not so often deprived of a room of their own in which to write. That's why automatically they will be disturbed, because they were, they have to share their rooms, they have to perform so many duties. That's why the need of money is, has been discussed as a theme in this text. The narrator implies women will remain in second place to their creative male counterparts. The financial discrepancy between men and women at the time of Woolf's writing perpetuated the myth that women were less successful writers. How can they write? They don't have their room, they don't have the money. How can they write? Okay, and that's why women have been blamed that you cannot write because you don't have the intellectual, you don't have the potential to write. And that is the thing. Now, another most important thing that has been discussed in this essay, A Room of One's Own, that is interruptions. Women are always been interrupted. Sometimes, whatever you are doing, so many important things you are doing, you are writing, you are thinking about something. Okay, but the thing is that someone will call you that you have to do these tasks, and after that you can write. But basically you can write, because when you are interrupted, you, your flow of writing, you will definitely forget what you are writing. And that's why she has discussed this theme, interruption. Okay, when the narrator is interrupted, she has created one narrator. This narrator is not Wolf. Okay, she has invented one narrator. When the narrator is interrupted in a room of one's own, she generally fails to regain her original concentration. Obviously, you will forget what if sometimes you have started writing and someone has interrupted you. That just come here, you do your task and then you start writing. That is not the thing that you won't do. You will forget whatever you are writing. Free of interruption are doomed to difficulty and even failure in their works. While the narrator is describing Oxbridge University in chapter 1, she has discussed the theme in chapter 1. Her attention is drawn to a cat without a tail. So she was invited to Oxbridge University to give one lecture. And while she was giving the lecture, what happened? She has seen one cat without tail. All her attention has gone there. And she could not remember what she was talking in that very lecture. And that is, she has given this. This is the example of interruptions. The oddly jarring and incongruous sight of a cat without a tail, which causes the narrator to completely lose her train of thought, is an exercise in allowing the reader to experience what it might feel like to be a woman writer. So this is the, she is given this example while she was just giving the lecture, and everyone was so much listening to her patiently, and disturbed by she had just looked at the cat without a tail, and she was just thinking, hey, this is a cat without a tail, and from where it has come, and she has been thinking about that, and she has already forgotten whatever she was saying. And this is the taste of a female writer, because whenever a woman is writing, she has been interrupted by so many things. Okay, I am laughing because I have a daughter sitting there and crying, and I'm doing this lecture. So this is also an example of interruption. Because I am also thinking about her being a mother, it's very tough not to think about your baby. She's 14 months old only. And then experience what, this is, I'm just giving you an example of interruptions. To be a woman writer, although the narrator goes on to make an interesting and valuable point about the atmosphere of her luncheon, she has lost her original point. She has already forgotten after looking at the cat. She has already forgotten whatever she was talking. And that generally happened to a woman writer. This shift underscores her claim that women who so often lack a room of their own and the time to write cannot compete against the men who are not forced to struggle for such basic necessities. women cannot have a room of their own. The men are always given their room, their space. They have been served throughout the ages. They have been served with the food, whatever they need. All the things will be served to them. But women have to cook. Generally, I'm not telling that everyone does that. Things are changing. Things are changing for better. But generally, at that point of time when Wolf was writing, she is telling about the then society. Okay, when she was writing, most of the women, they don't have the opportunities. They have so many less opportunities than the men, because they cannot write. They don't have the basic necessities to be fulfilled. And now, the subjectivity of truth, another theme. Okay, another theme that is recurrent ideas in this A Room of One's Own. In A Room of One's Own, the narrator argues that even history is subjective. History is subjective because history is written by men. And there is no, you cannot find one example. Okay, this is very interesting. Listen to this carefully. Because history is subjective, because that is written by men. Whatever women are doing, you cannot find one authentic example. Whatever women are doing in that age, because the history is written by men, and that is very much subjective. They have written the thing from their point of view. Okay, I'll give you one very interesting example. What she seeks is nothing less than the essential oil of truth. But this eludes her, and she eventually concludes that no such thing exists. The narrator later writes, when a subject is highly controversial, one cannot hope to tell the truth. Because when women are writing, okay, there are women writers who have taken pseudonyms because they know if they are writing and people will not respect or value their writing, that's why they have taken pseudonyms, means duplicate names of men, for selling their writings. Okay. So whenever they want to, she said that whenever you want to write, you have to show one to hold whatever opinion one does hold. You have to write through fiction, whatever truth, as a woman, whatever truth you want to tell, you have to tell it through fiction. You cannot say it bluntly, okay, being a woman. And one cannot hope to tell the truth. One can only show how one came to hold whatever opinion one does hold. To demonstrate the idea that opinion is the only thing a person can actually prove, she fictionalizes her lecture, claiming fiction is likely to contain more truth than fact. Reality is objective. Rather, it is contingent upon the circumstances of one's world. This argument complicates her narrative, or forces her reader to question the veracity of everything she has presented as truth so far. And yet she also tells that the fictional parts of any story contain more essential truth than the factual parts. With this observation, she recasts the accepted truths and opinions of countless literary works. Basically, through this point, she wants to say that because history was written by men, so there is no authentic description of women as per given, because it has been written by men, so there is no authentic description will be found in their literature, in their writing. That is the point. Okay. So it is almost 8:45. Okay, I'll just give you some character analysis. I'll give, but in a very brief way I'll give. Okay, because we'll have to discuss now. You have so many questions, maybe. So before I'll just sum up after some time. Let me just discuss. Just point out the characters. Okay, there are many characters in this text, in this essay. First one is I. I is the character. This essay started the character called I. I is an universal writer, okay, because she said in the call me Mary Beaton, because the I has not given any particular name. Call me Mary Beaton, Mary Seton, Mary Carmichael, or by any name you please. It is not a matter of any importance, because the I has not been given any particular name, because I, on behalf of every woman, she has been saying these things, whose process of reflection on the topic women and fiction forms the substance of the essay. So this is one of the character I, but she has not been given any name because she has an universal appeal. Okay. Now the Beadle, another character, very important, interesting character. An Oxbridge security official who reminds the narrator that only fellows and scholars, quote, okay, fellows and scholars are permitted on the grass. Women must remain in the gravel path. Women must remain in the gravel path. So the thing is the beadle. Beadle is a kind of security guard. Okay. While she was going for a walk in the university campus, a security guard came to her when she was just walking over the grass. Okay. A security guard came and said that you cannot walk over the grass because you are a woman. Only fellows and scholars are allowed. Because you are a woman, very silly thing, because you are a woman, you don't have the right to think and walk over the grass. And there is a pavement is there, you can walk over there. And this is also symbolic because a path is already made. In the patriarchal society, already a path has been paved by the patriarchal society, by the men. Okay, so you have to go through that part only. And if you just digress, if you want to walk over the grass, you can't. You are not allowed to do that. Whatever has been, the path has already been chosen or given to you, and you have to follow that path. Now, another character is Mary Seton, student of Farnham College and friend of the narrator. Okay, I'm saying that very briefly because there is, time is a bit limited, I think. Then Mary Beaton, the narrator's aunt, whose legacy of £500 a year secures her niece's financial independence. So she gets her financial independence from, because Mary Beaton, her aunt, has given her the financial security. Now Judith Shakespeare, as you know, she, Wolfe has invented one imaginary sister of William Shakespeare as Judith Shakespeare. Okay. And then Mary Carmichael, a fictitious novelist, contemporary with the narrator of Wolfe's essay, in her first novel, she has broken the sentence. Wolfe has very much loved this writing of this Mary Carmichael, another fellow writer, women writer, that she, her style of writing is very good. The sentence broken the sequence and forever changed the course of women's writing. She is very much impressed with this writer. And her name she has given, like fictional character only, Mary Carmichael. And then Mr. A. Mr. A, you can say that Mr. Assertiveness or Mr. Arrogant. Like an imagine male author whose work is overshadowed by a looming self-consciousness and petulant and assertiveness. Whatever he is writing about male and from their male point of view, and everything he has written is full of assertiveness. Okay. And the character of narrator. I'm just giving you a brief idea of this character because the thing is going lengthy, I think. The unnamed female narrator is only the major character in A Room of One's Own. She is the major character, that is the narrator, whoever is narrating this essay. She refers to herself only as I in chapter 1 of the text, and she tells the reader to call her Mary Beaton, Mary Seton, Mary Carmichael, or any other name you please, because she is an universal character and she is voicing the problems or struggles of women in general. Okay. Now, to conclude, we can say that start with the line, a woman must have money. Okay, this is the gist. Or to conclude, we can say that a woman must have money and room of her own if she is to write fiction. And this famous line written by this Virginia Woolf tackle head on the question. Okay, the question was that women are bad writers, they don't have potentialities, they don't have intellectual enough, they are not intellectual enough to write anything good. But that is the idea. She has tackled with this very line, she has tackled the head on the question of why men rather than women had authored a large proportion of the greatest works of literature. All the things. Till this Virginia Woolf writing, most of the writers were male. Okay, the prominent writers, and even in English literature, if you are a student of English literature, you will know that most of the ages, okay, the prominent writers are men, and that's why the age were given their name only, the age of Shakespeare, the age of Chaucer. Okay, you know that. You know that very well, because the prominent writers were those men. So that's why she is saying that rather than women had authored a large proportion of the greatest works of literature, writing in 1929, Wolf argued that the future of women's participation in art and literature depended on altering deeply entrenched ideas about their capabilities and suitable aspiration. Okay, it is not their capabilities, but they are not given basic necessities. their necessities has not been fulfilled. Her essay Rumor Forms Own spoke of education as the key to women's emancipation. So education is very much needed. Rumor has advocated that idea. If you want to do something, if we want more of women writers, we have to give mass education to the women. Wolf thought education could provide women with a voice they could use to contribute the to culture, and sought to highlight the discrepancies between men and women can hope to achieve in a patriarchal society. So the mass education is needed to build the gap, to fill up the gap between men and women, because they have been women have been like they have been given, they were not given any kind of opportunities, okay, throughout the ages. So they will need time to build up the gap, to fill the gap. The central idea of our essay was that women have not been given the space in which to think. They're again talking about the space to think, read and develop as intellectuals. They don't have the time, they were not given the time, the space, and financially they were not independent. They were required to stay at home and get married and have children. Nothing was given to them other than that. And rendered dependent on men for financial security, she noted women have historically lacked both the material means and the legal freedom to voice their own ideas. Even they were not given the right to vote. Okay, so how can they write? They cannot write. They were not given any political rights, any economic rights. They were not given any rights. How can they write? They were just treated as second citizens. Wolf illustrated her point by inventing a fictional female character, Shakespeare's sister, that Judith we have already talked about. Wolf's essay suggests that William Shakespeare's success was not solely the product of his talent, because no doubt he was talented. He was very much talented. But the thing is that he has been given opportunities as a man. If Shakespeare was born as a woman, he was not have given any opportunities. And then what would have happened? We would have lost a great mind like Shakespeare if he were a woman. If he were born as a woman, then we would have lost him, because he would not have been given any rights, okay, and he would not have been encouraged like his counterpart Judith had to commit suicide. Like that, he would have lost him too. Had he been born a woman, he would not have the opportunity to write. He would not have given, we as a society would not have given him the right to, opportunity to write, and we as a culture would have missed out on a great deal of poetry, place and influence. That is the thing. If you are a woman, he would not have written anything, and we would have, as a culture, as a society, would have lost that great mind. Then Judith Shakespeare was created by Wolf as a metaphor that I have already discussed so many times, and then has historically placed women, but the silencing of her character, okay, the important thing, the silencing of her character serves to remind readers of the limitations that society has historically placed on women. But we are invited to wonder how many literary great minds have been, if any aspiring women writers have been granted the same chances as their male counterparts. Because women were there, they had talents and all these things, but they were not nurtured at all, they were not given any kind of opportunities. And that's why we don't have any like prominent women writers in those ages. Now, again, today, Wolf's essay is still studied. The importance of this essay, Wolf's essay is still studied as a foundational contribution to modern feminist thought. So via this text, she has, text in literature, we call everything a text. Okay, it maybe can be a novel, a fiction or anything. Like one single sentence that has been written in newspaper caption, that is also called text. That's why I like prefer to call text rather than essay or novel, okay, or fiction. So via these talks, she wanted to promote financial independence of women, and if women have been given the financial independence, then only they will have the opportunity. They will be given the opportunities and they can write and produce good literature. And some of the women she has appreciated, some of the women who has been writing in that age, and she has said that for our daughters, okay, as a woman, for our daughters, we have to create a better society for women. And we have to start right from there. We have to voice our experiences, and thus we can make a better world for our future generation and daughters. Thank you. Now I will welcome questions. If you have any,
thank, Thank you so much, ma'am, for your enlightening, entertaining, and vibrant lecture, I would say.
Thank you.
And I really believe, and I honestly would say that you made it very simple to make the students understand about the life of Virginia Woolf as well as the text itself. And your lecture has really delved deep into those things, whatever you have covered. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your.
Thank you so much, Mangal.
Once again. Now the session is open. It is an interaction session. So I would request all those participants to place their doubts, and if they have any discussions, they can put forward. Chat box, you can type in the chat box if you find it difficult to ask questions, or you may also ask the questions for your voice. Thank you.
And one more thing, if you want any kind of help, you can call me over this chapter. You can call me, okay? Because I have notes over there, means on this text. And if you can contact me via my email, via email or via my number, you can have that number from the post. Okay.
Ma'am, we would give some more time for the students so that they could post their question.
Okay, if you want to write it down. The various things you want to know. First, the gender inequality. You can write it down actually. Gender inequality. Gender inequality, first one. Then second, the importance of money. Then interruptions. The various problems that you face while writing. And then the subjectivity of truth. Subjectivity of truth means the all the literature that have been written by men, that are written by male point of view, that is the subjectivity of truth. Any more questions? Yes, that is the last line I have said. No, the last line I have said today. It's like in modern times too, whose essay is still studied as a foundation. Okay, these are the foundational foundation works. Like they are the pioneers in women's writing. Okay, contribution to modern feminist and foundation. They are like pioneer writer, and they have written enough. They have just started writing, and they have said whatever they have to say, and they have voiced, especially Woolf have voiced the various struggle that was there was an idea that women are. They are not intellectuals, okay, they are not intellectuals, they cannot write good, they cannot produce literature, produce good literature. Male counterparts, as per se, the male counterparts, as a man, men are like, they write, they have produced, throughout the ages, they have produced only literature, okay, good piece of literature. Now, after the advent of feminism, we have like dig. Okay, we have digged so many writers, very not prominent writers are there. Afraben and all these writers are there. And they are, when she was writing, she was they are the pioneers, okay. And they have started writing about feminism and about, they have been voicing the women's experiences. Women experiences, Woolf. She has, first of all, via this essay, she has given, she has highlighted the point that women need education. If you want good female writers, we should give mass education to women. Okay, and if women were given education, then only they can write. And they also, the basic necessities, like the women should be given opportunities to produce better. To produce better literature, like their counterparts. But we have to start somewhere, and we'll say that we have to start somewhere. And some of the writers, women writers like Bronte sisters, Jane Austen, they have started. Then just we have to follow the tradition. Any more question? Please repeat the question. It has just come and go. Please, can you repeat the question, please?
Ma'am, the question is there in the chat box, which read, is dominance upon women one of the mandatory characteristics of patriarchy? Because we are now living in a patriarchal society, but we have our freedom. Or now the patriarchy is reformed in the role of time. That is a question from Madhurika Soikia. It is available in the chat box, ma'am.
The thing is that dominance, the female dominance is basically female dominance or a characteristic, you know, you cannot say that this is one of the prominent features of patriarchy. Patriarchy is a system where men generally are dominant women. Okay. But the thing is, this you cannot say that this is the feature. It is a system, and there are so many. This is one of the systems of for the society. There is matriarchal society we have in our Northeast. Okay, we have a matriarchal society in Northeast, and so patriarchy is one of the forms. And in patriarchy, most of the time we see that the thought process in the matriarchal society. Okay. Especially the alpha male. There are you have already like you know about the masculinities. The heterosexual alpha male, they just want to dominate the other sex. It's not that the male counterparts, the men who are not alpha male, like they don't want to the men who have their different sexual preferences. They are also not. They are also dominated by men. Okay. And one more thing I can say about that. That because the thing like rape and all this domestic violence, okay, so sometimes this kind of thing are also like surface. This kind of thing also people say that men are also being raped. But the thing is that do you think that female most of the time women rape men? No, it's men are also being raped by the men, the alpha men, who think that he is less of a man because he has some attributes, he has some other sexual preferences. Okay. So whenever in patriarchy we only give importance to the alpha male, okay, the heterosexual men. So women have been dominated in this patriarchal society. Men, there are men who are not like heterosexual. Who patriarchy is very interesting. The thing is that there are set rules for men and women too. So if men generally they don't behave in a certain way. That is the characteristic of alpha or heterosexual alpha male. And if you don't behave in that way, then you won't be considered as a man. Okay, and there are so many things have been written, and in multimedia also we see that kind of things. Okay, and that's why menism is a part of feminist studies, gender studies now. So it's not, we can't say that women are only dominated in this structure of society. Men who are sympathetic, they can't express their thoughts, they can cry in front of others, and all this set of rules are there. And these are the characteristics of heterosexual men. You cannot say that these are the characteristics of patriarchy. Patriarchy is the system where male dominate, and this male dominance is, you cannot say that this male dominance is only over women. The men, this alpha male who think the other kinds of men, masculinities, there are other studies. You have already heard about these masculinities. Okay, there are different sects are there. Okay, characters. I should say the characters. No, if you want to write, I can give you the. After that, I will go to that question. Okay, another question was there. First, let me. Thank you. Let me name the characters, okay? I, within a double, like I as a quote, I is the character, okay? One of the characters is I, is an universal woman writer, okay? The next one is the Beadle, T-H-E-B-E-A-D-L-E, Beadle. I hope you are writing, no? Then Mary Seton, M-A-R-Y-S-E-T-O-N, Mary Seton. Then another character is Mary Beton, M-A-R-Y-B-E-T-O-N. Okay. Another character is Judith Shakespeare, J-U-D-I-T-H-S-H-A-K-E-S-P-E-A-R-E, Judith Shakespeare. And then Mary Carmichael, Mary, M-A-R-Y. Then Carmichael, A-C-A-R. M I single word, okay. Carmichael, this is the surname. C A R M I C H A E L, Carmichael. Okay, and the main another male character is there, main letter, that is Mr. A, A capital, Mr. dot A, like those arrogance writer, arrogance male writer she was talking about. And the most important, the protagonist of this essay, that is the narrator. The narrator, N-A-R-R-A-T-O-R. There was another question. Please, can you show me the question? Or read out the question, anyone, please? Excuse me, there was another question. Can anyone please read out the question?
Another question says, from this is a question from Apsana Satachali. Very great. Okay. Ma'am, gender stereotypical roles are creating challenges for both men and women.
Yes.
In spite of these challenges, why people are following these stereotypical roles? That is a question from Apsana Satachali.
Okay, that is, yes, I got the question. Actually, the thing is that this is a system, okay? And this system, it has been giving privileges. There is a term called male privilege. Okay, male privilege is there. And those society as a whole, because we have been living in this kind of structure of society, patriarchy, where alpha male were given the most importance. Okay, not all kind of male. A homosexual man is not given like importance. Okay, he cannot, he has been as ridicule, derogatory terms have been used to describe him too. That's why the alpha male has been given most of the rights. And that's why they have maintained very tactfully they are maintaining the system. And you have not read that book, that sexual politics, okay, Kate Millett, Sexual Politics. There were three reasons are given. Why this, yours one is a very good question. Why this patriarchy is perpetuating? That means continuity, the continuity of patriarchy. Why? There are three reasons. First one is religion. The pseudo-religion, religion, they systematically, they have religion, they have used that systematically for the continuation of patriarchy. Another main reason behind the continuation of patriarchy is, that is capitalism. I'm giving you the example, okay, that is a very good capitalism. First three things, let me just name the three things that is the reason behind the continuation of patriarchy. First is religion, that is the pseudoscience, and the second one is pseudoscience, and the third one is capitalism. Now let me tell you the religion in religious books. Okay, I don't want to be controversial here, but the religion preaches and so many things that are, you cannot, being a woman, you cannot do these things, and nobody just logically think why a woman cannot enter a temple during her menstruation. When you are going through your period, you cannot enter a temple. You will just abide by that, because religion is the biggest tool that has been used by patriarchy for the continuation of it. Okay, and then the second thing is pseudoscience, because most of the time people think that without men you cannot have the pseudoscience that a father is everything. Okay, that promotes the thinking that father is everything, that without a male person, that is the pseudoscience that gives you the idea that men are the creator. Okay, men are the creator in the sense that without them you cannot create a child. Okay, that is the thing, and that is the pseudoscience. It has been proved that there are so many things. Okay. And the things, heterosexuality, all these things also come in this pseudoscience thing. and then capitalism. Capitalism is a system where these they have created so that you as a male child you have to wear blue, as a female person you have to wear pink. All this because it is only benefiting. It is not benefiting the society. It is only benefiting the system. That is a capitalist system. It increases their sales. Okay, and that's why this capitalism is everywhere. That is consumerism. Okay. So if they create and there are you have heard of pink tax? Have you heard of that thing? Pink tax. Pink tax means the if you buy one shampoo, okay. If you buy one shampoo, there will be one shampoo for male and one shampoo for female. But the thing is that the female shampoo will be costlier than the male, and that is they are not directly imposing tax, okay. But the female products are always costlier than the male products, and these only benefit capitalism, and that's why they don't allow. Okay, that's why they don't allow to go get rid of this system. I think I have answered your question. And for further reading, if you can read Kate Millett, that will be very much helpful.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Okay, so I think that is done from the student side, I think. There are no more questions coming in, or there is no more questions pouring in. So with this, we will end up our interaction session. And the next program that we have is a word of thanks. So I would like to give this, I would like to hand over to Dr. Dibhojyoti Bora for the word of thanks.
Thank you, Mongol. On behalf of the Department of English, I'd like to offer my vote of thanks to our principal, Dr. B.C. Bhumia sir, for offering all the possible help to organize this particular add-on program on gender studies. Also, I'd like to thank our HOD, Dr. Dipa Phukan Borua ma'am, for offering all the possible help. I'm very pleased that we have Dr. Mithuk Prasad with us, and I thank her for her very illuminating and insightful lecture today on A Room of One's Own, one of the very, very important feminist essay written by a very important writer of all time. Thank you, Mithu. Again, I thank the listeners here who actually really listened to her lecture. And also, I think that participate very attentively with her discussion. And I thank the participant for that. And last of all, I thank our moderator, Sir Mongol Singh Rongpar, for very beautifully conducting this session. Thank you, Mongol. Also, I would like to announce that tomorrow we'll have an offline class at 12 noon, and it will be delivered by Dr. Dipa Phukan Borua ma'am on Komala Das and Introduction, a very famous poem written by a very, very famous feminist writer. Thank you again. And I offer to Mr. Mongol.
Thank you so much, sir. And with this, program for today comes to an end. Once again, I would like to extend heartfelt gratitude to our Mithu Baidu. Thank you so much, ma'am. And thank you so much, everybody, all the participants. Have a nice evening.
Thank you.